Hello dear students, this is Praful and I welcome you all to my YouTube channel, that is One Page Biology. In today's video, I will be discussing one important question which has appeared in 2017 Biology NEET paper. So the question is, phosphoenol pyruvate PP is primary carbon dioxide in. The options are C3 plants, C4 plants, C2 plants, and option number D is C2 and C4 plants. Now dear students, in order to understand the answer, watch the entire video. Dear students, first we need to understand what are C4 plants, what are C3 plants, what is the difference between C4 and C3 plants, and of course what is C2 plants as well. So as far as C4 plants are concerned, dear students, these are some of the examples of C4 plants. You can see that there is maize, sugarcane, sorghum, amaranthus. These are all different examples of C4 plants. What is the specialty of C4 plants? Specialty of C4 plants is, these plants basically can survive at a very high temperature. That means these are tropical plants. They can perform photosynthesis at a very high light intensities. That means basically these plants are much more better evolved in comparison to the C3 plants. That's the reason why, dear students, they can basically tolerate high temperatures. At the same time, a very major important factor in case of C4 plants is, these plants do not perform photorespiration. Dear student, what is photorespiration? Photorespiration is basically a wasteful process which occurs in C3 plants. Now dear students, why is it wasteful? For that we will have to understand the concept of C2 pathway, and I will try and make a separate video on C2 pathway. But as of now, try to remember that photorespiration is not a useful process for plants. It is indeed a wasteful process. Now C4 plants basically avoid photorespiration, and as a result, dear students, they basically conserve a lot of energy. As a result, dear students, they are much more efficient compared to the C3 plants. Going ahead, dear students, what is exactly the structural difference between a C3 plant and a C4 plant as far as their leaf anatomy is concerned? So if you compare the leaf anatomy of C3 and C4 plants, you can very well see that in case of C3 plants, the cells of the leaves, what are the cells of the leaves called? These are known as mesophyll cells. So in case of C3 plants, the mesophyll cells are of two types. So there are upper rectangular cells, as you can see in this part. These upper rectangular cells are often referred as palisade mesophyll. Whereas the lower circular cells, the mesophyll cells, these are known as spongy mesophyll cells. Whereas in case of C4 plants, you can see that the mesophyll cells are arranged in a circular manner only, right? So there are large mesophyll cells which are basically arranged in a circular manner, inside which again there are mesophyll cells only, and these are spongy mesophyll cells, but they are again present in a circular manner, like basically a covering. That means, dear students, here basically the arrangement of C4 plant leaf anatomy is slightly different. Now of course you may wonder that why such a difference in case of C4 leaf anatomy, dear students. You will understand this when we understand C4 pathway, dear students. Now dear students, such a particular arrangement of mesophyll cells in case of C4 plants is known as kranz anatomy. What is kranz anatomy? Now try and understand. As we just said that inside the leaf of a C4 plant, we can see that the mesophyll cells are arranged in a circular manner, inside which there are again mesophyll cells, the spongy cells, which are basically arranged in a circular manner, and inside that there are conducting tissues which are nothing but xylem and phloem. So this particular arrangement of mesophyll cells, which is basically like a necklace or a wreath, is known as kranz. So kranz means basically wreath or a necklace, dear students. So this particular arrangement of mesophyll cells is called as kranz anatomy. So now that we understood the anatomy of C4 leaf, let us understand the C4 pathway. Now as we said that in case of C4 plants, there are outer mesophyll cells and the inner circular cells, which are known as the bundle sheath cells. Again, let me show you. The outer green cells are called as the mesophyll, and the inner cells, which are known as the bundle sheath cells. So C4 pathway, dear students, occurs in two cells, that is the outer mesophyll cells and the inner bundle sheet cells, and that's why you can see that this entire pathway is divided into two compartments, that is the mesophyll cell and the bundle sheet cells. So first we will understand what exactly occurs in the mesophyll cell and what happens in the bundle sheet cell. So let us understand the first part of the C4 pathway. Now in the first part of the C4 pathway, here you can see that the first compound over here is nothing but phosphoenol pyruvate. So can you make out the difference, dear students? Here the first carbon dioxide acceptor is phosphoenol pyruvate, whereas in case of C3 plants, who is the first carbon dioxide acceptor? It is nothing but RuBP, that is basically ribulose bisphosphate, which is a 5-carbon sugar. So in the first step, carbon dioxide is added to PEP, and what is formed is a 4-carbon compound, which is nothing but oxaloacetate, right? So in this particular step, one phosphate is lost, right? So now the first stable compound in case of C4 plants is nothing but oxaloacetate. And that's why, dear students, this is known as a C4 pathway. Now in the next step, what happens is oxaloacetic acid undergoes reduction. What do we mean by reduction? Reduction means simply addition of hydrogen. So oxaloacetic acid undergoes reduction to form something called as malate. So the question is, who donates the hydrogen to oxaloacetic acid? Dear students, the hydrogen is donated here by NADPH2. That means here NADPH2 gets converted into NADP+. Okay, so it's a simple reduction reaction. So now, dear students, the first half of C4 pathway is done. That means now malate is formed in the mesophyll cells. Now, dear students, once the malate is formed in the outer mesophyll cells, this malate is going to transfer into the inner circular cells, which are nothing but bundle sheet cells. So as we said that now the malate has been formed, this is going to get transferred into this bundle sheet cells, right? So in the next step, as you can see, the malate has been transferred to the bundle sheet cells. So now once the malate has been transferred into the bundle sheet cells, what is going to happen? This malate gets converted into a 3-carbon compound, that is nothing but pyruvate. So what is this particular reaction? This is a simple decarboxylation reaction. That means from malate, one carbon dioxide has been lost in the form of carbon dioxide. Now, dear student, this is a very, very, very important step in C4 pathway. Why? Because the carbon dioxide which has been lost enters into Kelvin cycle, which is nothing but the C3 pathway. So this is the most interesting part of C4 plants, dear students. That means in C4 plants, both the pathways are occurring, that is C4 pathway as well as C3 pathway. But dear students, you have to understand that where is C4 pathway occurring? The C4 is occurring in the mesophyll cells. But where is C3 pathway occurring? The C3 pathway is occurring inside the bundle sheet cells. Also, what we have to understand is the carbon dioxide here is not the atmospheric carbon dioxide. Here the carbon dioxide is basically generated in the plant itself, that is in the reaction when the malate gets converted into pyruvate. This carbon dioxide is released and this is entering into Kelvin cycle. That means, dear students, C4 plants basically are evolved to use its own carbon dioxide, right? So that's why, dear students, we consider C4 plants as much more efficient plants compared to the C3 plants. Now going back to the pathway, dear students, we said malate gets converted into pyruvate in a simple decarboxylation process. Now this pyruvate finally gets converted back into phosphoenol pyruvate, which was the first compound in case of C4 pathway. Now dear students, this particular pyruvate converts back into phosphoenol pyruvate, which was the first compound in the C4 plants. That was nothing but phosphoenol pyruvate. And how does pyruvate get converted into phosphoenol pyruvate? Simply by the addition of phosphate, which is donated by ATP. So ATP gets converted into AMP and one inorganic phosphate is released, dear student, which is also known as pyrophosphate. So this PEP, which is formed now in the bundle sheet cells, that is phosphoenol pyruvate, gets transferred back into the mesophyll cells. So that means again the PEP is regenerated so that the C4 pathway can again occur. Okay, students, now that we have understood the concept of C4 pathway, I am pretty sure that you will be able to answer this question. So dear students, the question was, phosphoenol pyruvate is primary carbon dioxide acceptor in, option number A is C3 plants, option number B is C4 plants, option number C is C2 plants, and option number D is C2 and C4 plants. So of course, we just now saw the pathway. We all know that now PEP, that is phosphoenol pyruvate, is the first compound which is the primary carbon dioxide acceptor in case of C4 plants, dear students. So I hope, dear students, you have understood the concept of C4 pathway. In case of any doubts or suggestions, please do mention in the comment section. So this is Praful signing off. See you all in the next video with some other biology related question, dear students. Till that time, take care. Thank you so much. Bye bye.